Hello, hi, namaste. This is Avi, your master teacher of chemistry at Vedantu. Welcome to the session. Hello, good evening. Hey, yo. Okay. Good evening, good evening. Can you all see and hear me? Yes. Okay, I'm live, right? Hi Shambhavi, hello. Oh, that's so sweet. Hi Shriya. Hey Shrilata. How are you? All good? Hey Pranav. Yes. Good evening, good evening. So today I will be telling you about top 10 chemistry research institutes. Of course, it will be helpful for you in the future if you think, केमिस्ट्री में कुछ कर लेंगे. सो आई बी टेलिंग यू व्हाई दीज इंस्टीट्यूट्स आर कंसिडर्ड एज द बेस्ट एंड इट्स नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया अराउंड द वर्ल्ड बिकॉज यू नो व्हेन आई थॉट ऑफ परस्यूइंग अ पीएचडी आई स्टिल वांट टू डू इट इन जापान. आई एम स्टिल थिंकिंग. सो आई वॉज वेरी मच कन्फ्यूज बिकॉज आई डोंट नो लाइक विच इंस्टीट्यूट इज गुड, विच यूनिवर्सिटी इज गुड. सो आई डोंट वॉन्ट माई स्टूडेंट्स टू फेस द सेम प्रॉब्लम. दैट इज द रीजन वी हैव कम अप विद दिस session where I will be telling you about top 10 chemistry research institutes. Are you ready? Yes. Hello. And make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet, and share this video with your friends. Thank you so much. Ready? Yes. Hey, hi. Dhaira, I always mispronounce your name, I know that. Hi Hardik. I am not very sure, unstable. I really want to pursue my PhD because I want to learn new things and I feel like I'm not an expert and I have so much to learn. Okay then, let's get started. So the thing is, most of them are Chinese universities and I was like, you know, it was not about what do they offer, it's like how to pronounce this word. Like, so I might be mispronouncing these words. I'm sure it won't be the right pronunciation because however it looks like, it is not the pronunciation, right? So please, please forgive me for that. If you know the right pronunciation, you can help me with that. Okay? Hi Harry Potter. Hey Siddharth, what happened? Siddharth, you're laughing. Yeah. You know, I was not even worried about like what I have to tell about this university. It's about, it's so difficult. So the first one is Chinese Academy of Sciences, a very, very, very good institute because it is famous for its enormous size. So it has 105 institutes across China and it supports 60,000 research staff. That's a lot. Because, you know, according to me and even my seniors told me, like, the guide whom we will be working under and the laboratory is very important whenever you plan to pursue, or, you know, maybe the research assistant or the PhD student, it is very important. So if you look at the number of institutes and the research staff, then obviously, yes, it is very good. So chemistry focused institutes are the highly productive institute of chemistry. So it is based in the Beijing, and when the Dalian Institute of Chemical Physics, it specializes in the area of chromatography. So not everywhere you will find the advanced equipment. You don't know there is this equipment called as NMR. Do you know this? NMR? Hello Ramya. Hi. Hey Anusri. Hi Malhar. Hi Thunder. No. I know. So it's an equipment, okay? So which will help you to recognize or identify the number of what kind of bond is there between carbon and hydrogen. You know, you have synthesized some compound. I don't know what it is. So using this NMR, I will know. And one, this instrument costs around 2 to 3 crores. 2 to 3 crores. It's not in lakhs. Did you know that? Especially when you are researching, there will be a lot of synthesis and you require a lot of equipments. So whenever you are planning to pursue your PhD or the research, it might be biology or physics or chemistry, make sure the institute has very good laboratory. That is very important. Yes, our college had one. Our college had one where I did my master's, but we were not allowed to go and actually use this instrument. So we had to pay around 100 rupees or 200 rupees per sample so that they would give us the result. For students, it was free up to some samples. Yeah, I know, right? Hi, Hardik. Hello. What happened, Malarji? Hi, I hope you are doing good. Jo bhi hai, smile. Yes. So the catalytic chemistry, it's mostly physical chemistry because it comes under physics, na? So they are focusing on the branches of physics here. Okay, I have started already. I'm in the second institute. The next one is French National Center for Scientific Research, which is in Paris. So here it is the largest governmental research organization in France and the largest agency in undertaking basic research, that is the physics, chemistry. So it gets almost $28 million. Then obviously, as I told you, the equipments, everything must be good because what else will they do with this money, right? So its Institute of Chemistry supports 12,000 staff, including researchers, teacher researchers, engineers, technicians and administrators across 133 labs. Whoa. Because you know, like whenever you are pursuing PhD, obviously you won't be like, it is very difficult for you to manage both. Okay, yes, there are some amazing people who works along with that, they'll try to complete their PhD. So the institute, the university will provide stipend as well. Hello. So hi Shreyansh. So it depends, you know, like why that institute is good. It depends on the scientists or the professors who are working there, or maybe the professors or anyone, researchers who have done this tremendous job in their fields. So we have such people from this institute, that is French National Center for Scientific Research, that is Alejandro Franco. When he was 13, he actually patented for hydrogen fuel cell. Isn't that great? Like even at 15, 16, we are like, ma'am, hydrogen kya hota hai? Ma'am, periodic table mein kitne groups hai? Kitne periods hai? But this man, Franco, when he was 13, he patented his first hydrogen fuel cell. So I'm not telling this just to see, compare, okay, they are very smart. No, every one of us, we have that potential. It's just that, you know, you have to think and you have to keep experimenting, whatever it is. Do not restrict yourselves. Textbook, I'll just finish it and then done. No, you never know. You might win the next Nobel Prize. Who knows? This is what I keep telling you, right? Most of the inventions, discoveries are an accident. So you also keep trying because Surabhi ma'am will be always supporting you. Anna? Yes. High five. Unstable titan, it depends. So organic chemistry, so like 4 to 5 years hoga. Physical chemistry, thoda sa aasan hai, like three years. Ha. Very good. OMG, I know, right? Most of the facts, you know, if I just keep reading, when I tell, keep telling you, you will be like, what? OMG, oh, I didn't know that. We have one more very nice person, Raffel. So he was the first scientist to win the Tetrahedron Young Investigator Award, which is awarded for those exceptional chemists under the age of 40. So that will make the institute, like, you know, obviously more valuable, right? Hi Kalpana, hello. Usually 3 years, on an average 3 years, but it depends. Yes. So next is Max Planck. We all know him, right? Don't you? Yes. Huh? Okay. So this is in Germany, Max Planck Society. So chemistry is fundamental to the Max Planck Society, as the name suggests, right? So its Institute of Chemistry was one of the first established within the German research organization, एंड सो इट वर्क्स लाइक ऑब्वियसली ऑल द फील्ड्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री के ऊपर रिसर्च होगा इन दिस इंस्टीट्यूट. I haven't done my PhD yet. I want to pursue. That's what I said. Otherwise, I would have added doctor before my name, na? Huh? Okay. So, from what all fields they usually conduct research in this particular society, which is in Germany. So, ranges from investigating the chemical processes in Earth's foundations to understanding how cells communicate. The Max Planck Institute for Chemical Energy Conversion. So it was re-established in the year 2012. It focuses on the storage of energy like wind power and the solar power. So I really like organic chemistry. So I want to, you know, work on some, compounds which have this antibacterial or antiviral properties. That's what I want to work on. Okay, so next is, again, it's a Chinese university, Nanjing University, which is in Jiangsu, China provision. So this university owns the China's oldest chemistry department. It was launched in the year 1920. Can you believe 1920? Oh, almost 100 years ago, right? Almost 100 years ago. 12th organic is hard. It's okay, we are here, we'll help you. So then at the National Southeastern University, then it was converted into National Central. What is happening? I don't know. I can't even see myself. I'm just teaching. But it was renamed to National Central University, and then again they changed it to Nanjing University in the year 1950. So it produces the country's highest profile chemistry research. They own two labs, okay? One is the State Key Lab of Coordination Chemistry and the State Key Lab of Analytical Chemistry. So coordination chemistry, do you know the structure of hemoglobin, children? Hemoglobin? Yes. Class 10 chemistry is going to start. When? Yes, do you know the structure of hemoglobin? There is iron atom, and then when I was talking about teaching you about the working of oximeter, I had showed, na? Hi, Bauwerk, hello. Hi, in thunder. No, hey, come on, I had told you. As a iron, and then there will be four units. Do you remember? So like there, you know, there are other different compounds where the one of any metal, okay, so it is surrounded by more than, usually you will see only four bonds, now there can be six bonds. So that is what is coordination chemistry, which focuses on coordination compounds. So for that they have a separate lab, and then analytical chemistry to aapko pata hai, hai na? Hi Shashwat, hello. So this is for life science, a very rare point of difference for a university in China. It's School of Chemistry and Chemical Engineering boasts 101 full professors. They have 101 professors. Oh, that's so nice. Imagine learning from them, right? Including 5 members of the Chinese Academy of Sciences, and runs one of the oldest doctoral chemistry programs in China. So I don't know now, like, whether you are able to actually digest the importance of these university, why you should go for the best university and all that. At one point, you know, maybe once you're done with your 12th, then you will realize how important the colleges which you want to enroll are. So then also these videos might be useful, but why I'm doing it now? Because I want you to realize how important the universities or the institutes are. Okay, as I told you, the laboratory se lekar, professors, and how famous the institute is, that also counts. Because whenever I say, I've done my master's, the first question is like, from where? Nobody will ask you for the percentage. It's like, from where? And when I say MIT, you're like, oh, MIT, then good. You know, that name carries a lot of weight. So please keep that in your mind as well. Which great university for quantum chemistry? That we have to check, Malhar. I'm not very sure. Okay, so next is again, this is also in China, Peking University, Beijing, China. So, how big it is? Can you see? Yes. Good, no? So, it was the first public comprehensive university which was set up in the year 1898. So, since then, it has been considered one of the best universities among the two universities which they have, the best two universities. So, right now, I'll be telling, and the next will be the Tsinghua University. I'll be telling about this university in the next slide. Okay? Yes. So in 2018, its position in the categories for chemistry, physical sciences, earth and environmental sciences and life sciences were 5th, 11th, 10th and 39th. So chemistry is 5th. Whoa. So its budgets are more limited than Tsinghua's. In 2018 and 19, its overall budget was $1.82 billion. Can you see? Yes. So of course we have Dhairya, but you know, like when we look up the best 10 universities for chemistry, then these are the ones. Of course, if you want me to do a separate video on the research institutes which we have in India, of course we have some amazing research institutes, IISc in Bangalore, we have it, but top 10, yes. Yes, yes, G. So next is Tsinghua University. Again, it is in China. So as I told you, the last one, Peking and Tsinghua, these are the best two universities of this country. So it has made an impressive progress in chemistry in recent years. So if you're wondering on what basis are we telling, are we considering these institutes as the best? It's about the papers which they have published and the research that has been done. Okay, so it's about the paper, like what are you working on, the students, the professors, what are they working on, how many papers have they published, so how many new compounds must they have been synthesized, or are there any areas, you know, which they are working on, which has proved very useful. So based on all that, we say, okay, this is a very good university or institute for research. Ha, it's most of them are from China. So this is 7th, is also University of Science and Technology of China. So it was established in the year 1958 in Beijing. The University of Science and Technology of China was launched to drive the higher education of the country's top talent in interdisciplinary science and technology. So, you know, usually if you just see the Asian countries, they focus more on science, the basic research. So, and you know, whenever like we want to pursue PhD, like if you choose any of these universities which are in the Asian region, you need to work really hard because they are very strict. There is this, rumor also going around. But it's nice. So next is this, everyone knows the MIT, finally, a university which everyone knows. Hana, hi Suvidha, hello. This is, you know, this is one of the top university for everything, but chemistry ke liye, it has this 8th position, a very good university. So, it appears in several top 10s, right? You look for the engineering or anything MIT, say if you have a PhD degree, then like, wow it is. But even in science also, chemistry field also, it has done a very good job. So, it is, of course, it is in top 10. 2019 annual tables for chemistry, physical science, life science, academic institutions and the global 10. So as one of the world's most prestigious higher education institutions that we know. So Massachusetts Institute of Technology, like commonly called as MIT. We have one more MIT in India as well. You know that? Right? Hi Shomalya, hello, yes. We have one more, like you know, where I pursued my master's from MIT. That is Manipal Institute of Technology. But that is also a very good college. If you actually search for top best institutions, like our college also has some place within 25 or 50 ranks. Hi, hello. Yes, I know the area. Hey, Dhruv. So from like, you know, it's been at the frontier of research for more than 150 years. So it usually emphasizes on the entrepreneurship and applied science through close ties with the industry. So it does not mainly focus on the basic science, but the applied science. Okay. All are good. So the next one is Northwestern University, which is in Illinois, United States. This also you must have heard. So this is a private research university which was founded in the year 1851. And now it has campuses around US in Chicago, Doha, Qatar. And employs 3,300 full-time research staff. It has an annual budget of $2 billion. And it attracts more than $700 million for sponsored research each year. Because you know, like if you have these... First, for every research, the university has to fund us, okay, for buying the chemical or anything, you know, to carry out that particular research from the beginning to the end, they have to spend money. So that is the reason usually if you see the research ke liye, the money, the budget will be usually high. So here it is $2 billion. Whoa. Yes, they are very good. So Northwestern University is the second fastest rising institute among the top 10 in high quality chemistry research. So now like even though it is in the 9th position, it is growing very well. Maybe next year it might have gone up. We do not know. So the last one is the Stanford. You must be knowing another very good university. Top 10 mein in all the fields, I guess this will be there. So even in chemistry, so it is in the United States, it's a very good university, you know, getting a seat in these universities are not at all easy. So of course not at all easy, but of course we can try, right? Kriti, I'm not very sure about the state, you know, the particular university name, but I can get back to you. So chemistry was one of the 25 founding departments at Stanford University when it opened in the year 1891. So the department awarded its first undergraduate degree to Charlotte Ray in the year 1894 and its first PhD in the year 1907. So they tried to predict the existence of neutron in the year 1920. See, so the William Draper Harkins, who pursued their PhD, who got their PhD in the year 1907 and in the year 1920, so they predicted the existence of neutron. So this is about the top 10 universities for chemistry research. Okay, so this is only for chemistry. Of course, there are some amazing research institutes in India as well. You might be wondering why there is no institute from India. So when we look at top 10, these are the institutes. So if you want me to make a separate video on the universities or the institutes, research institutes which are based in India, then do let me know in the comment section. I would be happy to. Yes. Biochemistry, where Kriti? I don't know, I have a problem. Is it my phone or I can't see? I don't know how. Anyway, in my phone the live has not started yet. Just give me a minute, okay? Okay, now it does. Now I can see. Where? Yes, of course, you will have different, you know, research ke liye, you will get, I guess, all the subjects. It's fine. You will get it. I am not. Let's not do that. I want to. Yeah, let me pursue first and then you can call me. It's not that easy, children. It's not that easy, but I want all of you to think, give it a thought about it. Because science is a beautiful subject and learning about it, imagine it's not only about learning something has, you know, someone has already done or made a theory about and all that, but you will be doing your own research. You will be trying to synthesize a compound which has never been synthesized. Isn't that so great? Hana? That's nice. Sai Pranam. Hello, hello Raghav. Rita, no, I have not. Hey Arju. Haanji, once it's done, I'll let you know. How to get the admission there, Kriti? Yes, I'll do that. Okay, noted. Oh, acha, you're Thunder Insan. I have not done anything. And now if you want to join us, see, because here though, like, to get into these colleges, you have to really work hard and your marks has to be good. So why don't you join us on Pro Subscription, where you can get 100% knowledge and score 100% marks, because here we will be teaching you the general chemistry, which everyone can watch. But if you want to complete your academic syllabus on time, revise with notes, handwritten notes of the master teachers, with lots of tests and assignments, then visit the link which I have put in the description. Because now that we have made you this promise, Vedanta Improvement Promise, where if you feel like there is no improvement, because we are guaranteeing that there will be improvement in your performance, but if you feel like there is no improvement, then you will get your course feedback without any questions asked. So for more information, you can just visit the link which is given in the description. And if you need discount, you can use the code SURPRO, but that would have, if you once click on the link, the coupon code would have been applied already. So come and join me, because I am taking a lot of batches this year for 9th CBSE and 10th CBSE. So the medium of teaching will be English. So if you have not joined yet, you can actually ask them to enroll you into my batches, where I will be teaching you the CBSE 9th and 10th chemistry. So thank you so much for attending my session. I'll see you soon. Till then, take care. Chale? Yes, more classes, less price. How? Because all you have to do is just visit the link which is given in the description and in the pinned comment as well. Use the code SURPRO. So for class 6 and 7 also, if you want to learn from us in the Pro subscription, you can actually buy any of the course, Light, Classic, yeah, premium. So you can try it for 1 month. If you like it, you can buy the entire course. So the only difference is premium or classic mein aapko doubt solving app milega, and premium mein you will get a personal mentor. That's the only difference. Other than that, all these live interactive sessions, in class doubt solving, tests and assignments, notes, you'll be getting it in every plan. Okay, but all the micro courses, every micro course, you know, if you want to enroll into any micro course, it will be completely free. You do not have to pay anything. Please one unmute me here. Acha, there. I'll do that. So there are so many students who are actually studying, and you know, they are in my long-term course, so you can ask them as well if you are still confused. Okay, I'll see you in my regular classes on the portal. Till then, please take care. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello.